your basic average girl, and I'm here to save the world. You can't stop me, cause I'm impossible. There is nothing I can do, and when danger calls, just know that I am on my way.
Call me, give me, if you wanna reach me, when you wanna page me, it's okay.
I just can't wait until I hear myself on radio.
Doesn't matter if it's day or night, everything's gonna be alright.
Whenever you need me, baby,
call me, beep me, if you wanna reach me. Kim here, so what's the
message? Message clear, I am here.
Let me reassure you,
I'm never gonna leave you alone.
Reach me.
Two, one.
I'm Gracie Tacker, and I'm here to present Volleyball's Teacher of the Week to Miss Kazimba. Miss Kazimba, you won Volleyball's Teacher of the Week.
Oh, that's so
thank you.
That's so
all right, I would like to thank my fans. Without y'all, I wouldn't be here. So I just want to say thank you. Thank you. From the deepest of my heart, thank you.
Miss Kazimba got Teacher of the Week because she's such an amazing teacher, and she's always there for her students, and she makes her class fun.
At the Expo, there are 10 career pathways. We want you to get all up involved and ask questions, get immersed in these pathways, so that you can continue to explore the career that you want to pursue.
Hi, I'm Janelle San Juan. Most high school students don't know what they want to do after high school. We're here at the Career Expo event at the Landry Center.
All right, hi guys, I'm here with Career Tech. I'm in the health science program and I came with them today. So far I've done the magnet thing where you put your hands on a electric globe and it sends electric impulses through you and your hair stands up. I got a lot of candy and it's been a great time so far.
Okay, so we're with the Department of Architecture at the University of Memphis. So we're just talking about kind of what we do on a day-to-day basis and kind of explaining like what architecture school actually is and what you would really be doing. Kind of talking about some like common misconceptions about architecture and kind of explaining those sort of things. Talking about like what you would be doing and the things you might enjoy or that would help you in architecture school and things like that.
Michael Winter, I'm with Fleming Architects in Memphis, and I'm representing AIA Memphis, which is the American Institute of Architects. We're here representing all the architects and designers in our community. So we've got a great booth set up to talk about what architects and interior designers do for buildings and the built environment. So we've got a great booth set up. We've got a drawing station for folks to come in and test out their drawing skills. We've got this great setup, which is a scale up, which is a way to do kind of build a model of a real building. And then we've got 3D modeling and also virtual reality to communicate our designs.
The Career Expo event is a great way for students to learn about all the different opportunities they can take after high school. I'm Janelle San Juan. See you next week.
Who discovered America?
Christopher Columbus.
That's correct.
Let's go!
What's the name of the first American Constitution?
Bill of Rights.
No?
The Constitution?
I just thought it was the first Constitution. I didn't know there's a name for it.
It's Articles of Confederation.
Yeah. Articles of Confederation.
In which state did Thomas Edison die?
Virginia.
No.
Vermont.
No.
Idaho.
No.
Ohio.
No.
Hampshire.
No.
Mississippi.
No.
Massachusetts.
No.
Pennsylvania.
No.
Boston.
Out of state. Who wrote the Declaration of Independence?
Thomas Jefferson.
Who was the, what year did Texas become a state?
1856.
Close.
Who's close?
1854.
No.
1853.
No, you're getting closer.
1855.
1852.
No.
1851. 1851.
No.
1857.
1849. 1848. 1890.
1850.
1847. You're close. 1846. You're close. 1845. Yes. Oh my God.
Name seven
presidents. Thomas Jefferson, George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, Andrew Johnson, Andrew Jackson, Barack Obama, and Donald Trump.
Who discovered America?
All right, that's it.
So this week, we're going to try a little bit of 5-second challenge with the teachers. Let's see how it goes. Name three Disney movies in 5 seconds. One Mississippi.
Lion
two
King,
Mississippi.
Seven,
three Mississippi.
Dwarves.
Four Mississippi. Five Mississippi. Ah, you're a loser. Miss Venema, you have 5 seconds to name three states in the northeast corner. Go. One Mississippi.
New Hampshire,
two
Vermont.
Mississippi. That was solid.
Go.
You have 5 seconds to name three Netflix shows. One Mississippi. Two Mississippi.
Peaky Blinders.
Three Mississippi.
Four
things, Mississippi.
And
five Mississippi.
I can't do it.
So loser! Miss French, you have 5 seconds to name four other schools in the county. One Mississippi.
Fernando.
Two Mississippi.
Olive Branch.
Three Mississippi.
South Haven.
Four Mississippi.
Lake Corman.
Yeah! Good job. Nice work. Miss Minnie, you have 5 seconds to name four major holidays. One Mississippi.
Christmas.
Two Mississippi.
Easter.
Three Mississippi.
4th of July.
Four Mississippi. Five Mississippi. Oh, you loser! Loser!
So
Stafford?
Yes?
You have 5 seconds to name three brands of shoes. One Mississippi. Two
Nike,
Mississippi.
Adidas,
three
Skechers.
Mississippi.
Yes!
Skechers. Chris Farmer, name three restaurants on Getwell Road. One Mississippi, two Mississippi,
Nukes,
three
Chick-fil-A,
Mississippi,
Zaxby's.
Four. Yeah, there you go. Hey, give me some. There we go. Miss Fields, you have 5 seconds to name four MLB teams. One Mississippi, two
Houston
Mississippi,
Astros, Atlanta
three
Braves, the Boston Red Sox, St. Louis Cardinals.
Mr. Pierce, you have 5 seconds to name three sports without a ball. One Mississippi, two Mississippi. Three
cheerleading.
Four Mississippi. Five Mississippi. Hey, we wear something for me. What's the hell you're holding? Miss Nichols, you have 5 seconds to name four colors of the rainbow. One Mississippi. Two
red,
Mississippi.
Red, purple, yellow,
three
green, blue.
Yes!
Yeah!
Great job. Miss Mead, you have 5 seconds to name who said these two quotes. Pivot. And the opposite of man is jam. One Mississippi.
Okay,
two
Ross
Mississippi.
For pivot,
three
the
Mississippi.
Quote is Joey.
No, you are incorrect.
No.
Loser.
No.
Miss Webb, name three types of candy bars in 5 seconds. Ready? Go.
Snitcher,
one Mississippi.
Milky
two
Way,
Mississippi.
Three
Mississippi.
Tears.
Yes. Give me some doubt. Miss Kazimba, you have 5 seconds to name three coaches at the school. One
Duggan,
Mississippi, two
Field,
Mississippi, three Mississippi,
and
four
Venema.
Mississippi. Hey! Yes, sir!
Hi, I'm Wesley Seitz.
And I'm Tiffany Gatlin.
And this is JAG News.
JAG News.
Let's hop right into the announcements. There will be no school next Tuesday due to the election.
Van placed second last weekend at the state championships. Congratulations.
Be sure to turn in your North Central Youth Leadership applications by the end of today.
Free tutoring is offered every week after school on Wednesdays in B22. To sign up, go to the office and get a slip and put it in the box.
Hey guys, Editing Tiffany here. I just stopped in to say that we forgot to congratulate the cheer team. Last weekend, they won first place varsity regional champs and super varsity game day regional champs. So congratulations, y'all.
Let's see what the forecast looks like for this weekend and next week with Janella.
Happy Friday, Jaguars. I'm Janelle San Juan, and here's your weekly weather forecast. Tonight we have a football game at home against South Haven. High for today is 51 with a low of 32, so bring a jacket. As of Saturday and Sunday, we are looking at a mostly sunny forecast. Highs will be in the 50s and lows in the 30s. For Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, it will be partly cloudy, highs in the 60s and lows in the 40s. And finally, on Thursday, we are looking forward to a clear and sunny weather. Highs in the 60s, lows in the 50s. I'm Janelle San Juan. This is your weekly weather forecast. See you next week.
Now, let's talk about sports for Johnny and Bubba.
But I'm hungry.
Me too.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there, but my name is Johnny.
I'm Jason.
And we got your sports news for you. Yeah. First, we're going to kick it off football, taking a tough loss, Tupelo, 35-7. Play the game, we'll give it to number 8, Branson Tittlewah. He was doing his thing out there, playing wide receiver, cornerback, defensive end, all of that. First, then also we're going to give it swim. They had their stakes this past weekend. Carson Jones getting first place in the freestyle.
Number 1.
50-meter and 100-meter. Let me tell you something. That's Michael Phelps for you right there.
Michael Phelps.
Austin Willis also got third place in the 500-meter freestyle. I'm telling you, that's some endurance right there.
It is.
Now I got upcoming games with both.
Football has a game today at home against South Haven, 7 p.m. Make sure to be there. Clear to watch, number 19, Jason Curry, quarterback. Basketball has our home open against Ripley Tuesday, 7:15. Girls start at 6. Make sure y'all be there. Look for number 11 and number 5, man.
That's all, folks?
That's it.
All right. Catch you next week. That's all for sports news. See y'all later.
Sin City was a maybe.